making this homemade apple pie. It's very good looking. All right, so let's begin. I will be making a homemade apple pie. You are going to be needing 2/3 cups of shortening and 2 tablespoons of shortening. So that's that. Then you're going to need 2 cups of all-purpose flour and 1 teaspoon of salt and 4 to 5 tablespoons of cold water. We're going to need for our that was for the dough. Now you're going to make the ingredients, get the ingredients ready for the actual filling. So you're going to need 3/4 cups of sugar, a 1/4 cup of flour, a half a teaspoon of nutmeg, a half teaspoon of cinnamon, and a pinch of salt. And you're going to need some apples. You're going to need one big green Granny Smith. And then 6 of these red apples. Or if you want, you're going to need something about. You're going to be needing tart apples. So anything that's tart. Okay, so. And then after that, you're going to need 2 tablespoons of butter. You're going to need a pie pan, a rolling pin, a peeler for your apples, a fork or a pastry blendy thing. All right, let's begin. We are going to be getting our 2/3 and 2 tablespoons of shortening and our 2 cups of all-purpose flour and salt. And you're gonna combine it in this bowl. What these sort of look like little round balls or peas or whatever. Now we are going to add our 4 to 5 tablespoons, one each at a time, and then you're gonna take a fork and you are going to toss this. And then it'll form our dough, and you keep adding until you think the dough is formed. All right, I'll get that fork and we'll come right back. So here is our first tablespoon. And this water has to be cold. Because it'll make this good. So, of course, we're going to need another one. So that's two. I'm just gonna keep doing this and I'll show you what it looks like all mixed up. Okay, so you'll combine your dough and then you'll make 2 equal balls out of them, so we can make a bottom pie crust and a top pie crust. If you guys don't want to do the making of the dough, you can buy store-bought and you just roll it out onto your pan and then you can go directly to making the apple pie filling. But if you're making your dough, then we'll do this step now. So you are going to lightly flour your surface. This actually might be too much, so let's see. We'll put some over here, I guess. And you're gonna take one of your balls and you'll flatten it like this. And then you'll just take the rolling pin and roll it out, and I'll show you what the full-size one looks like. And roll it out. It doesn't have to be exactly perfectly round. It's big enough that it'll fit in here. So what you're gonna do is you're going to roll it up onto your rolling pin like this, so you can pick it up. And then you're gonna bring your pan over, and then you're just gonna unroll this, like this. Like I said, it's not perfect. So with the excess of it not being covered, you're gonna take the hanging over stuff and you're gonna fill in your crevices. rip your access off to patch up your holes that you have. So, like, right here. This is one here. Oh, sorry, my hands are in the way. So you'll just take your access, and then there are some right here. So you're just gonna take and just fill it in. Now you're going to set your oven to 425 degrees. We are mixing the 3/4 cup of sugar, the 1/4 cup of flour, and the 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon and nutmeg. And the salt. A pinch of salt. So we're going to get a bowl and we're going to put that together. So let's do that. We are going to put our 3/4 cup of sugar. Our ¼ cup of flour. And nutmeg, cinnamon, salt. So that's our 1/2 teaspoon of each cinnamon and nutmeg. And just a pinch of salt. So I'll put that in here. And then you're just gonna mix this like this. So now we are going to cut and peel and cut our apples. So let's go do that now. So to peel your apples when you have skin on them, you're just gonna go like this and take off your skin. And you're gonna do that to all your apples. So the next step, if you have an apple core, you could just push down and then cut it. But I can't find mine. So what we're gonna do is we'll cut this in half. And then try to cut the core out. And you want these into wedges or just pieces. All right, I'll show what those look like in a minute. We are going to cut our apple. So you could either cut it this way or you can cut it like this. This is a little trickier if you get the core. And then you're gonna try to find the star. So, we can cut the core out. So you're just going to keep cutting, and then you cut the core out, and then you just chop them into pieces. We have chunks that look like this. Now we are going to mix this, because our flour and cinnamon and sugar are at the bottom. So just mix it up. I'm going to go get a spoon and mix this up, and I'll show you. Just let these apples sit a few minutes so that the juices will marinate with the apples. You can let it sit here while you're doing just like a few, like maybe 20, 30 minutes. You don't have to let them sit. This is the way I like to do it. I like to let them marinate. You don't have to. You could directly put them in your pie pan. All right. You're going to put your apples into your pie tin. Make sure you get all the juices out from your bowl here. Now you're going to dop your pie with margarine. So you're just going to take little bits of your pie crust, I mean your margarine, and you're just going to stick them on top of your pie, like so. So all over here, and then I'll take the same thing as before. You're going to take your second piece of dough out, you're going to roll it out, and then you're going to do like you did before. You're going to place it on your rolling pin and then place it on top. So let's see, so let's roll it out a little more. Alright, so you're just gonna pick it up like before. This guy's a little flakier than the other one. Okay. So I pick it up. It's alright if it falls apart a little bit. You're gonna bring your pie in and you're gonna release it over the top. You may have to move it around. If you have holes like before, like we did in the base, you just take the leftover excess and then you could patch it up, and then you'll have your whole pie covered. So now we are going to spread the other tablespoon of butter that we have got, and you're just gonna spread it out like this on here. And yeah, so just keep putting the other tablespoon of butter on. Really good. We're gonna sprinkle some sugar on top of the pie here. Now either you can take a fork or a knife, but you're going to poke a couple of holes into the top here so that your crust can breathe a little bit. Okay. Crimp or take a fork and just go like this all the way around to seal it up. Yeah, alright, and I'll take you to the next step. Take out some foil and make some strips to put on your edge, and we are going to put this in the oven. You're going to take this foil off your pie at last 15 minutes of baking. We are going to bake this to 40 to 50 minutes. So we're just going to pop this up in the oven and I'll show you when it comes out what it looks like. This will be what your pie looks like when it's done. When it comes out of the oven, you're just going to let it cool and then you can serve it. Alright, I hope you like, comment, subscribe, and I hope you make this homemade apple pie, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!